Today is a great enough amazing incredible day because it's a Germany day. Crazy German laws. Six surprising things that are forbidden in Germany. Without further ado, let's get into this reaction. Let's go.
But illegal in Germany? Here are six crazy German laws that you should know about. Hello, servus, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Felicia. I'm originally from Munich, Germany, but I've been living here in Cincinnati, Ohio, on and off since 2016. Now, whenever people here in the US find out that I'm German, they usually ask me a bunch of questions, and one thing that I get asked a lot is if Germans are really as obsessed with rules and laws as they're often portrayed. And my answer is usually, not every single German loves rules, of course, but yes. Overall, following rules is definitely something that is valued a lot in Germany, and Germans like to have regulations and laws for almost everything. However, some of those laws can be really surprising and funny, and that's why today I'll tell you guys about six crazy German laws. Now, of course, I'm not going to make you read any long, complicated, wordy laws in German in this video, but if you wanted to be able to read and understand those laws, I would recommend learning German on Babbel, which is today's sponsor. Since school has started again and the year is slowly coming to an end, I've been getting more and more messages from you guys asking about my tips on learning a new language as one of their New Year's resolutions, and you may not have fully started that yet, but I have great news for you, because with Babbel, you can start speaking a language in just 3 weeks, and you can actually get up to... Now, law number one, it's illegal to run out of fuel on the Autobahn. As most of you probably know, the...
It's illegal to run out of fuel on the Autobahn. Makes sense, because people, there's no speed limit, right? So you don't want to run out of fuel. You imagine running out of fuel somewhere you can't slow down, really? Or you don't want to, you can't stop, really, because it's dangerous. It makes sense.
Autobahn is Germany's interstate system. If you want to learn more about it, you can check out these two videos. And when it comes to driving, there are indeed a lot of regulations that you have to follow as a driver in Germany. Like, your car has to pass inspections every 2 years, called TÜV, otherwise you're not allowed to drive on the streets. You also have to have certain equipment, like a first aid kit and warning vests in your car. And in the winter, it's mandatory to have winter tires on your car. And yes, you're also
I think that's really good. I'm very responsible. We don't have that in the UK. They don't make sure you have winter tires, even though you should.
Obligated to always have enough gas in your tank as a driver, and if you don't and actually run out of gas on the Autobahn, you can be fined and might have to pay 25 up to 120 euros, since this is considered preventable. And in general, it's also illegal to stop or park on the Autobahn, even in the emergency lane. I mean, unless your vehicle is actually breaking down, but even then, you won't see a lot of cars just left there on the side of the Autobahn. Whereas in the US, you regularly see broken down vehicles on the side of the interstate that were just basically parked there. And of course,
same as our motorway in the UK, like, you'll see, you'll just pull over, and if you're broken down, you're broken down. So what do you do if you're broken down in Germany? And like, do you have to push your car up the Autobahn? Like, they like expect you to not be there? It's a bit weird, but okay.
Since most places in the US don't use radar traps to enforce speed limits, but have cops pull people over instead, you'll often also see a car that was pulled over and also a cop car behind it in the emergency lane as well. On the German Autobahn, that would actually be considered jeopardizing the road safety, especially since on many parts of the Autobahn, there is no speed limit, so people are going crazy fast. Fun fact, apparently this also became illegal in a small town here in Ohio earlier this year, in Youngstown, which is close to Cleveland, so don't do it there either. Number two, it's not allowed to name your baby Superman. Now, this one isn't technically a law.
What do you mean, Germany? This cannot be real. It's not a real law. You cannot name your child Superman. First of all, why would you want to name your child Superman? Second of all, why is that illegal? Why would that be illegal? If I want to name my kid, I don't know, grass. I don't know why I thought of grass. I want to name my child grass. He was born in the grass. I'm going to call him grass. I don't expect someone to say you can't name your child something. So that's a bit of a weird law. Superman.
Law, and you won't get fined for this, but fact is, and this is usually hard to believe for Americans, that in Germany, you can't just give your baby any name you want. It'll have to be approved by the local Standesamt, like the civil registration office, and there are rules as to what you can and can't name your kid. I mean...
That's a bit weird. That's giving communism. I'm sorry, that's very much giving communism. What do you mean you cannot name your child? There's certain things you can't name your child. If I would like to name my child something, I'll name my child. It's my child. I don't know about that, Germany. It's weird. It's a bit weird. I mean, Superman's a weird name. I don't think anybody should name their child Superman. However, if I would like to name my child Superman, I should be able to. I don't know about you. Let me know what you think of that in the comment section. They tell you what you can and cannot name your child.
Of course there are rules for that. It's Germany. We pretty much have a rule for everything. Now, whether the name you picked for your baby will be approved or not depends on different things, such as whether it's a name that actually exists, whether it'll be a reason for bullying later on in the child's life, and sometimes...
Yeah, but whose job is that? Bullying? Like, there shouldn't be bullying. Then that's the teacher's... The teacher should reprimand the child for bullying. You don't, like, say, no, you can't be that because you might get bullied. Are you going to say, don't be gay because you might get bullied at school? Like, sorry, I just hit the mic. That's a bit weird. I don't know.
They also don't accept names that aren't obviously a female or a male name, which this last one is kind of ridiculous if you ask me.
Wow. So you can't name a male, like, a feminine sounding name. Interesting. You might want to look at that. It's a bit strange. You should be able to name your child whatever you want.
Here are just some examples of names that have been rejected before. Waldmeister, Junge, which just means boy, Rosenherz, so rose heart, Bierstube, so kind of like a beer pub, Satan, or Satan in German.
Satan, I mean, choices. You could have just named your child Lucifer or something like that. Satan, wow. McDonald's,
Superman.
Pain.
Gucci.
What's wrong with Gucci?
Whiskey. Or the last names of politicians, like Schröder, which was Germany's chancellor before Merkel, or Lenin. And since I already see all these question marks pop up in your guys' eyes, no, you won't be able to call your kid Hitler either. Even though the first name...
Mate, that's what... I can understand that. I can understand that. But all the other ones, you should be able to call them.
Adolf is technically allowed. These rules are one of Adolf the reasons is. Why you won't find a lot of crazy first names in Germany, and also why Germans are often very fascinated by what American celebrities name their kids. Number 3, deny the Holocaust. Now, this one doesn't necessarily fit into a list of crazy or funny laws, because I think it's neither of those. However, many people from outside of Germany and outside of Europe aren't aware of this and find it a very interesting law when they first hear about it. It's illegal in Germany to deny the Holocaust. So you can't just say that the crimes of the Holocaust didn't happen. If you do, you can either get fined for it, or you can actually get prison time of up to 5 years. Now, I've read many...
Whoa! You guys take it... I mean, that was a crazy time, so I'm not surprised you have something like that in place, but just to say that it didn't exist, you get 5 years in prison? Whoa.
Any comments on the internet saying that this indicates that Germany doesn't have freedom of speech. Well, that's not true. We do have freedom of speech, Meinungsfreiheit, as a fundamental right in Germany. However, freedom of speech can be limited by other general laws, by provisions for the protection of young persons, Jugendschutzgesetz, and another person's right to personal honor. Those general laws, which are like the first example of what can limit your freedom of speech, cannot be laws that just discriminate against one specific opinion. They have to be neutral and they have to protect another legal right. In this case, the right that they're protecting is the dignity of the Holocaust victims and their families, which is something that we value very, very highly in Germany, because after...
Of course. Absolutely, completely agree, but at the same time, when I'm thinking about freedom of speech, is that freedom of speech if you can't say something without being in prison for saying it? It's absolutely wrong. It's horrible. It's detestable. I don't like that. to say that it didn't exist is a mockery to all the lives that were lost during that time, all the Jews, all the gays, all the black people in the Holocaust as well, all the people that were lives that were lost in the Holocaust, all the Brits, all the German soldiers. Yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy. Crazy to say that. However, when it comes to freedom of speech, to say that if you say that, you will be thrown in prison, that is the opposite of freedom of speech. That's a problem, Germany. I'm sorry. It just is.
World War II, when the Federal Republic of Germany was founded, the very first paragraph of our constitution, the Grundgesetz, became, "Human dignity shall be inviolable. To respect and protect it shall be the duty of all state authority." So that's why denying the Holocaust is illegal in Germany, even though we do have freedom of speech, and it's also illegal in 16 other countries.
It's like, you can't really say you've got freedom of speech if that's illegal. It's illegal to just say something.
Number 4, it's forbidden to mow the lawn on Sundays or play piano at midnight.
It's forbidden to mow the lawn on Sundays or play the piano at midnight. So play the piano at midnight. I totally get that. Nothing after midnight. Like, noise levels should be zero at midnight. It is antisocial and shouldn't happen. Call me old, but I believe that's so. So I'm with you there, Germany. But to tell me I can't cut my lawn on a Sunday is ridiculous. It's old-fashioned. It stems from religion, clearly. No, that's ridiculous. That should change, but no one cares for it to change because no one's bothered about mowing their lawn on a Sunday. But to say that you can't,
It's forbidden to mow the lawn on Sundays or play piano at midnight. Germans like silence. This is something you'll notice if you're ever in Germany, especially if you come from a louder culture like the American one. Germans tend to speak pretty quietly, especially in public. And we also appreciate having some peace and quiet at home, which is why there are tons of laws and regulations about how much noise you're allowed to make and when. Sundays and public holidays have actually been defined as rest periods, Ruhezeiten, for the whole day, which means that you're not allowed to make loud noises that could disturb others. This includes mowing your lawn or using a drilling machine, for example. So if you were trying to do some renovations at home, not on Sundays. This also applies to nighttime rest periods, which usually start at 8 p.m.
I get nighttime, but during the day, like Sunday or something, that's ridiculous. I'm sorry. I wouldn't like that. I think that's the only thing that would annoy me about Germany is the Sunday you're not supposed to make noise. No. If it's daytime, I should be able to make noise. It's day. As soon as it gets to nighttime, when the sun goes down, that's when you should start turning down all the noise levels. And when it reaches midnight, there shouldn't be any noise. I'm with you on that. But on a Sunday, that religious tradition, it's a religious tradition of Sunday's a day of rest, Sunday's a day, like, but that needs to go. Especially the shop opening times on a Sunday as well, that's ridiculous in 2024 as well.
PM, and sometimes even to lunch hours. The rules for the lunch hours usually vary though, depending on where in Germany you live, and some rules will even be made by the house management of your apartment building. The Federal High Court of Justice has even ruled that playing an instrument in rental apartments is only allowed at certain times, from 8 a.m. to noon and from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. And even then, you can only practice for a certain amount of time. Piano players only get up to 2 hours per day, and drummers, for example, get 45 minutes in the summer and 90 minutes in the winter. Yes, German laws are very specific.
Wow. I don't know what to say, to be honest.
Number 5, it's not allowed to keep urns at home. This topic doesn't really come up a lot in conversations in everyday life, fortunately, but the Germans among you may have wondered about this when watching American movies before, because in the US, it's pretty common that after a loved one dies, you take the urn home with you. I've definitely seen this in movies and shows before where either it's part of a comedic moment because someone doesn't realize that it's an urn, or of course, it's part of a drama. Well, that's something that you won't ever see in Germany because we have a law called Friedhofszwang, cemetery compulsion, that says that any mortal remains have to be buried at a cemetery, or alternatively, after a cremation, you can have a sea burial in Germany as well. Now, in the past...
What? So in Germany, you have to be buried? I don't know about that, guys. You need to fix that. When it comes to death and what happens to a loved one when they die, should be the responsibility, should be the ownership. It should be the family that decides what happens to someone who passes away in their family. I'm sorry. That's what the rules should be. The fact that your government can say, you need to be buried. Some people don't want to be buried. Some people want their ashes to be scattered. Some people want their ashes to be in a little locket that people wear. Some people would like to be in their household in an urn. I don't know about that. For me, I don't like that, to be honest. I think that's wrong, that you tell people that are grieving what they should do with their loved ones.
Last few years, the rules have been lifted a little in different states. In Bremen, for example, it's now allowed to spread ashes on privately owned property, but you're still not allowed to take the urn home with you. In general, there's pretty big differences when it comes to funerals and cemeteries in Germany and the US. I've actually had the topic on my list for a while, so let me know if you'd want me to talk about that more in depth at some point. And number six, you'll be punished for saying du to a cop. Okay, those of you who speak German probably understand this law right away, but for everyone else, du is the German word for you. Now, why would that be a problem if you use that with a cop? Because in German, just like in other languages like French or Spanish, we have a formal and an informal address. So depending on what relationship you have with the person you're talking to, you'll use a different pronoun and also a different grammar structure when you talk to them. Du is the informal pronoun for you, while capital Z is the formal one. The formal one is usually used with people who are significantly older, strangers, people of authority, or just people that you have a professional relationship with. It really depends on the specific situation, but if it's not a child or someone you're close with, you usually don't use the informal address with them until you two allow each other to do so. Now, since police are people of authority and you speak to them in a professional context, you use the formal address with them, Z. And if you don't, and use du with them instead, that can actually be viewed as insulting an official, Beamtenbeleidigung, because it's disrespect.
Wow. That's very strict, isn't it? So certain forms of language can be seen as disrespectful to a police officer. I guess if it's seen as disrespectful, I understand. However, I do firmly believe police are supposed to be community servants. They're supposed to serve the community. They're supposed to be a public servant. Their job is to protect. Their job is to look after. Their job isn't to use their authority to lift themselves above other people. Do you know what I mean? So why should I speak to you in a way that you won't speak to me? Does that make sense? I don't know how I feel about that, but hey.
Respectful, and you may have to pay 600 euros for it. What? The actual fines are decided on a case-to-case basis, but this is one number I found. I also found that showing a cop the finger gets you up to 4,000 euros. Now, technically, insulting an official is just based on the general laws of not insulting others. There's no extra laws just about insulting officials, but I would assume that police enforce this much more than regular people do, so you should definitely be careful here. But also, I'm pretty sure that they would only enforce it if you obviously do it on purpose, and if they can tell that you're a non-native speaker and try to speak German with them and just make an honest mistake, I'm sure it's not a big deal. have come across a few more very interesting German laws, like the ones about beekeeping, but maybe I'll mention those in the future at some point. For now, what other funny, crazy, or just surprising German laws have you heard of? Share them with me and everyone else in the comments below.
Very surprising.
And, of course, I have been thinking about also making a video about the craziest laws in the US.
Guys, some of these I'm very, very shocked about, like, which one? Naming your baby Superman. You can't name your baby anything you want. That's a bit weird. Americans love to name their babies, especially celebrities. Celebrities name their children weird things. Denying the Holocaust, I kind of get it. I definitely get it. I get it because I get it. I mean, it was horrific. Like, put whatever laws you want in place to protect the memory and the dignity of the people that died. That I can get over. Playing piano at midnight. That one for me was a bit... I understood the playing the piano at midnight. It's the Sundays. The Sunday. Mowing your lawn on the Sundays. You can't make noise on Sunday. That needs to be scrapped because that's an old religious thing and I don't think that should be in society anymore. Taking the ashes home. You know how I feel about that. That's crazy. And the cop situation. Fair enough. If he wants to be called certain, using certain pronouns to see respect, and that's something that Germans know is as respect, and Germans know if you don't use that, it's disrespectful. I get it. But it's interesting. Very interesting. The only one I'd have issue with if I like moved to Germany, I would like be confused about is probably the noise one. The Sunday noise. I would forget it's a Sunday and like I'd probably make some noise. Like maybe I'd film a video like this and maybe my neighbor would knock on my door and be like, you're being too noisy. That's the only one. But apart from that, I think I'll be all right in Germany as a Brit because I think we're quite similar in that sense. But yeah, really interesting. You're very strict. Very strict. Anyways, guys, thank you very much for watching. Until the next one, I will see you very soon.